cover your little face up. Do what you're told, I'll mess you up. Why don't you enforce mandatory rules? Here, take this red cup for you.
Do want to.
Grab your mask and pull it up.
Do want to.
Do what you're told, I'll mess you up.
Do want to.
Why don't you enforce mandatory rules?
Do want to.
I don't think you trust. A self-righteous rule mandates. I cry when officials turn to lies. Mask up. Why don't you give your little face up? Do what you're told, I'll mess you up. Why don't you inform that's my rules? Here, take this rank up for you.
Do want to.
Grab your mask and pull it up.
Do want to.
Do what you're told, I'll mess you up.
Do want to.
Why don't you inform that's my rules?
Do want to.
I don't think you trust. A self-righteous rule mandates. I cry when officials turn to lies. Self-righteous rule mandates. I cry when officials turn to lies.
With your red, why have you forsaken me in your lies? Forsaken me in your red, forsaken me in your lies, forsaken me.
Oh,
trust in
AI. A self-righteous rule.
Officials turn to lies.
Are we on?
We are now.
Oh, good. We're back for more. And there's a lot to talk about because we didn't have the show last week. We're still in transition with our house, and we're working on a lot of things. But we have IT Ryan with us once again. How you doing, Ryan?
Good.
Everything's good in your life?
Not everything.
Oh, okay. Well, that's unfortunate. And we have Deadpool in the hot seat. What's up, Deadpool?
What's up?
How you doing?
Good.
Just kind of good? Mm-hmm. Tired?
Tired.
Did you like that? We can't hear you. You have a mic, buddy.
Tired.
You can pull the mic to you.
How?
Pull it to you. Pull. And then you can kind of sleep there. See, you're all good. And Jack is at church. But he's doing some camp meeting, but he'll be back and we'll join the show. Until then, we have Scary Doll in the, therapy couch. And we have a lot to talk about. So today we're going to talk about Club's latest manipulation, how they're going to manipulate all you parents that bow down to whatever scam they're selling. We're going to cover all that. We're going to announce two top coaches in Arizona, according to me. It's according to me. And these coaches don't even know yet. But they'll know because I'll share this to them. And Jack got invited to MLS Next. We're talking about that. I'll show you the email of the invite. Did you get invited? Let us know. And Phoenix College update. What's going on with PC and how we're doing. And State Cup. We're going to talk about State Cup and all the winners. And GCU loses 2-0 to Washington. But did the officials screw that game up? Did you watch that game? Did you see what happened that completely changed the game? We're going to do a segment on Know Your Rules, and we're going to cover all that. But first, we're going to pause for a commercial break.
This episode is brought to you by CoachCamera.com, a place where you can get all your merchandise. Go to CoachCamera.com, click on the store, and buy the most expensive t-shirt you've ever bought or the most expensive mug you've ever bought. You know why? Because I'm featured on it. I'm like the Nike symbol. Once you put me on it, it's going to cost twice of the value. But more importantly, you're contributing to a wonderful podcast. You will sustain this podcast if you make... I'm sorry, Coach Cam. I can't do this anymore.
So apparently we're having an error on doing comments. So I'm sending a test. And if you're watching the show, go ahead and do a test run for us and comment and let us know it's working. Is it working?
We're in.
All right,
yep,
we're good.
That's good.
All right, so first up, we have GCU who lost. I was watching online. It was on YouTube Live. And GCU loses to Washington 2-0. But what really happened was officials got involved in a weird way, and it was all over a handball. What is a handball? Do you know what the handball rule is? Is it when the ball hits your hand or the hand hits the ball? What is the rule? But this one is interesting. So this is a perfect time to do a segment on Know Your Rules.
Learn your rules. You better learn your rules. If you don't, you'll be eaten in your sleep. Learn your rules. You better learn your rules. If you don't, you'll be eaten in your sleep. Learn your rules. Learn your
rules. So learn your rules. And we'll learn some rules with you today. What's a handball? So at the GCU game against Washington, Washington was up 1-0, but GCU early on in the second half had an opportunity to score. They crossed the ball in, and a handball happened. So, Ryan, go ahead and play that video. Is this a handball or not?
Challenge in ball one by Fernandez. Oh, is that a handball? No handball. Came off the foot of the defender and came up.
It is a handball. Absolutely is a handball. Arm is extended. What do you think? Is that a handball? Referee, both referees were very close. Did they make the right decision of a no call? Ryan, I think we have another video. Can you play the video that's zoomed in so we can take another look?
That's Chris Myers on the shot. Let's take another look at this possible handball situation. That's certainly
possible. I should have kept that video going because the video of it was so obvious. It's the hand was in a natural position. Is this natural?
It just bounced off his arm.
He kicked it into his arm.
On purpose?
It doesn't matter.
I think that's the dumbest rule in soccer. Personally, I think that's the stupidest rule in soccer. But if that's a rule, I've learned it.
He was doing the Hitler salute. That is not a natural position.
Running.
No. He kicked flailed his foot out, extended his arm, and that's unnatural.
Oh, Rick Tillmans agrees with you.
It's a handball. It's a
100% handball, says Rick Tillmans.
Of course it is. And the referees said play on. And this just happened to my college team on Thursday. We're playing Scottsdale Community College, and almost exact same play. No call. It was in the first 10 seconds of the game, and we should have a penalty kick right away. But these referees are scared.
Get penalty kicks for that?
Yes, Ryan, you get penalty kicks. So it changes the games. You should not get punished for being in the box, serving a ball, putting the... It's so frustrating. It changes the whole game. And what happens to GCU is that they got countered 2 minutes later and gave up a goal. And it always happens that way when a referee really screws up like that. And it was such an easy call that the other team benefits on it totally. So that's a big deal and something we got to deal with at the next level. Anyways, what do you think? Is it a handball? Of course it is. Did the referee make a major mistake? Absolutely. And it's a problem. And that's our segment on Know Your Rules.
Learn your rules. You better learn your rules. If you don't, you'll be eaten in your sleep.
What? Carlos says that referee was from Washington in North Carolina. Well,
that explains it.
That's unfortunate. What do you think, Deadpool? Why are you just staring at me? Creepy. Okay. All right. Deadpool just give me a blank stare of scary. Do you have any thoughts on the matter? Okay. I'm glad we mic'd you up. Yeah, so it's a handball. It's obvious. The referee apparently was from Washington. But these referees, you change the game completely. Just do your job. Call it. Don't get the human element about things about, oh, that's probably not fair. They just call the fouls. That's it. Just call the fouls. Be consistent and just roll with it. Just roll with it. And if you have to give 5 red cards to one team because they're stupidly violent, you give them 5 red cards. You just do it. It doesn't have to be even. For whatever reason, Deadpool, Ryan, referees feel like they have to keep everything even with cards. Like, look at the score sheet. They had 5 yellows. They had 4. The foul count was even. It was fair. No, that's not fair. That's what I would consider...
Communism?
Yes. But, like, an example, like, when you're dealing with money and dealing with concessions at Phoenix College a lot, you know, if it's always exact, then there's concerns. How's it always perfect? And yeah. And you work in retail. Is your cash register always perfect?
No, we were off like 75 cents today.
Yeah, it's always off. If it's always perfect, then you're going to like, what's going on? Someone's stealing, you know, kind of thing. Referees, same thing. It doesn't have to be, the foul count doesn't have to be even. And I know what you're doing. You're kind of like, you know, you have one AR maybe taking, you know, stats on how many fouls they were and the other AR doing that. And you're trying to keep it consistent so it's fair. That's not fair. There's a thing called a team that's really good, a team that's average or really bad, and it's different. The one that's in possession majority of the time will have less fouls. The team that has a packet in and counter will probably have more fouls. It's not even. Think about it. Anyways, I'll move from there. But it did spark a something we're going to do once the world opens in Phoenix. Will it ever open? Who knows? I'm going to set up a game. I got 2 games I'm setting up at Phoenix College. I'm going to have teams come in. I'm going to do 1 game. We're doing the point system game, which I've promised. And then the second game we're going to do is we're going to have referees like the officials for tennis. We're going to get these huge scaffolds, 1 on each side. They're going to call offsides, everything from there. They call from everything and see how successful they are and get some feedback from teams. Will that work? What do you think? Do you think referees, 2 referees versus 3 or 4, 2 referees up high with a megaphone just screaming about foul, you know, foul on number 5, right? And they can keep stats. That'd be good too. And call from that vantage point, because obviously on the field, the way the officials are being taught, you know, you got to be close to the play and all that. They don't see anything that close. Plus they're getting tired and all that. I want fat, lazy referees with good eyes perched up like they do for tennis. 2 of them and just look and catch everything from that vantage point. We'll save money, less referees. And if you get screamed at, you're protected on a perch. And we can give you water balloons or something like that. If coaches are yelling, you just hit them with a water balloon. But I think you'll get yelled at less if you are perched up.
That would be a fun way to red card. Red balloon?
You could. Be red card. I'm doing that. I'm going to do both.
Water balloons?
No.
You should.
No, I'm doing the point system game, and I'm going to do the official game and get feedback. We can change the game if we keep trying to experiment on these things, and I'm excited about doing those things. I just got to find a couple scaffolds that make sense. So we will be doing that. What do you think? Comment. Do you think that's a good idea? Should we try different ways? And I'm going to get real referees too. Put them up there and hear what they have to say, and then put non-referees like myself that actually will be honest and give an opportunity to see the game differently. Perched up. Club update. Here we go. So West Valley. I want to talk about 3 clubs right now. I want to talk about West Valley, Gilbert, RSL. West Valley links up with PSG. So how does that happen? So I found a way, or I went on Google and I Googled PSG. How do you become part of the PSG and how does that work? It's very simple. You buy it. Deadpool. You can buy it. What do you want to buy? Okay. Deadpool wants to buy nothing. But you can just purchase it. It's a franchise, and they're going to give you a curriculum and show you how to market and all this stuff and, you know, whatever. And they're kind of forced upon because you have to compete with the fake MLS Next, which we'll talk about a little bit later. But here's – I don't mean to be mean. I don't. I do feel bad, and I'll feel bad after, but I'm going to do it. Gilbert Arsenal, Pyramid of Greatness. Let's play that video, my friend Davey.
Soccer club is we were fortunate to be in the inaugural class nationwide and are the only club in the state of Arizona that is Players First licensed.
Only
Players
club.
First is a branded holistic
first.
Club soccer experience.
Sounds
for players
good.
And parents, which emphasizes the development
David,
of
you're
each
putting
individual
me to sleep.
To his or her full potential and helps parents make better choices about where their children should play.
You should. This is taking too long. Are
players
you able to speed
first
this
license
up?
Is created to
can you fast,
clubs
see if you can fast forward this thing. Oh, thank gosh.
Catching any of this?
Yes. Because you can just read it.
That's exactly what high school is like.
Yeah. Okay, cut that thing off. That's a, all right. So, Dave, all you need to do is go in between the slow talk and the speed and be somewhere in the middle and just go a little faster. Yeah. That's what we need to do. So Gilbert Arsenal is all about players first because they're not MLS Next. They're not good enough to be at MLS Next. They're not worthy. So they're part of Players First. They're part of this program. They're the only team or club that's affiliated in such a way. Okay. And then West Valley, worth PSG. Everyone has to find a way to market themselves. So you can't be part of MLS Next. That's only for the special people. Speaking of special people, our sales uniform company adds another club into surprise, I think. So RSL, all the clubs are the same, except they all buy the same uniform and someone's making a killing on uniforms. And I guess they can share players. But it's so annoying, like who you play in RSL, which one? I don't know. Who's in your bracket? RSL. Just one other? Three other. RSL, South, North, East, West. There's a lot. And I don't know how RSL can produce that many uniforms. It's shocking, but they are the biggest one. But it is sad to see that it's just everyone has a gimmick of we do it this way, we do it that way, and they kind of have no choice. It's all about MLS Next, right? Right, Deadpool? Yeah. How come you don't? You're not speaking.
When did you become mute?
Yeah. Why are you mute?
This is how we know you've never seen Deadpool.
Not
mute. There you are.
Do you have your swords?
No, they're inside.
Okay. All right. Well, it is what it is. But I believe the Pyramid of Greatness at Gilbertson is pretty cool. But there's good coaches, and we'll talk about coaches. There's good coaches in every club, and we're going to hit two clubs. RSL's one of them. They have a great coach, and we'll hit another club in Batavia we'll cover. Jack gets invited to MLS Next. I don't know if Jack's going to make it on the show. He's should be home soon, and he might call in, but we kind of butchered that in the pre-show. But hopefully he'll call in. You could actually text him and call in. But let's talk about Jack.
Like he'll respond to my text.
Yeah, we're going to Jack now. El Rojo. So El Rojo's not here.
That's crazy. Totally matched up with the video.
Yeah. Jack gets invited to MLS Next. Here's the email. What's the email say?
Hello. This is Mike Krause, Academy Director for RSLAZ MLS Next Teams. I wanted to reach out in regard to Jack Cameron. He has been scouted by one of our staff members, and I would like to invite him out to train with our 2006 MLS Next Team next week. Next week, we are training Tuesday through Thursday nights. We'd love to see Jack against our top players.
But so it says out.
It does say out. It
you
just
typed
took me
it
way
wrong.
Too long to figure out what that meant.
It's a personal email, Ryan. He even misspelled out.
Wow.
So it wasn't a copy and paste. He really took his time and misspelled words to let us know Jack is wanted. by the great Mike Krause. And thank you, Mike, for bringing him out.
He stamped it like the queen. Like,
yeah,
that's
all right.
Him and everything. That's like his whole business card right there.
I'm not going to lie. When I saw that, it was like, they think Jack's good. I like gave me warm and fuzzies, right? Right, Deadpool? Yeah, warm and feeling good. You know, kind of like our therapy couch with Crazy Doll. What's the doll's name?
Scary Doll.
Scary Doll.
Not we super need, scary.
We need
right
to send
now.
It to Dakota. Yeah, it's I felt so privileged. I'm like, they want Jack, but look where it is. So put the overlay on about where it's at, and where is it at, Ryan? Where's the tryouts at?
Which one am I? He's 2006, right?
Yeah.
Tumbleweed and Salt River.
Far, far away.
And Chandler and Scottsdale. Oh.
And it's deep, far, far away. So if this is supposed to be like the greatest players to come together at Tumbleweed and Salt River, it has to be the best. Versus centrally located where all the best players will come into. But that doesn't matter because MLS Next is RSL, SA Del Sol, Phoenix Rising.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Not the Arsenal. I don't know why. Arsenal's pretty good. But it's just another league, people. Everyone's getting caught up on this new scam. And I can't wait to replay this video. Well, I can and cannot wait to replay this in a couple of years when the next thing's going to be FIFA World Cup League. Be part of it. You'll be in the next World Cup. I mean, it's they're going to be selling something. Everyone's selling something because of MLS Next. The ones that were not worthy to be part of it, they have to come up with something to keep people believing in them versus just this. You want to be a good club? Just produce players. That's it. Just produce them. Look at this player. Video them. This is what they look like when they entered our club. They sucked. 4 years later, this is what the player looks like. Now this player looks like a baller because they're technical. But who does that? They don't. They rot. They rape. They pillage. They take over, and they just want them at the very end. Like, oh, they went to UCLA. They went to ASU. They transferred over here. Whatever. And they might only had them for a year. It's whoever's going to take the credit at the time versus are they technical? You got one job to do, Soccer Clubs of America. Make sure the players are technical and they're not scared to have the ball in the game. And the only way that's going to happen is if they're allowed to touch the ball, they're allowed to look up, they're allowed to make their own decisions. So when it gets to the next level and the next level beyond that, they're prepared. Your job is to prepare. Am I on this camera or this camera? I don't even know what camera I'm on.
Front camera.
Okay. But that's your only job. Back in the day, Santos, we knew what they did. When you got a Santos player back in the day, you're like, oh, they're technical. But you can't say that about any other club right now. If you get a Rising player, Del Sol player, Gilbert, well, actually, Gilbert, there is a knock on you guys. You guys kick the ball far and you crush people with athleticism. You're very good at that. It's not your fault. It's cultural based. I don't think coaches have much to do with it other than have some courage and really put those kids in a situation where they're forced to learn technique. Don't let them just kick the ball. Let them deal with pressure and let them fail so they have to go home and get better or they're going to not want to do soccer anymore. Not to get them to quit or anything like that, but we got to change what we're doing. What's wrong with... Oh, it's Wi-Fi over there. Anyways, long story short, we have problems and it's a scam. MLS Next is a scam. Not all of it. Majority of it, because it's just a scam, because that's what we have to do. Speaking of MLS Next still... MLS pledged a year ago to fill the void left when the U.S. Soccer Development Academy disappeared. In numbers, the pledge is about to get fulfilled. When U.S. Soccer Development Academy folded mid-April last year, MLS immediately promised to fill that void and then some, skeptics question me whether MLS would continue youth focus on only those most promising prospects, but MLS countered that certainly the league would continue to hunt and develop prospects, but any youth wanting to learn and play would get the chance. That chance would come in the new league youth organization called MLS Next. I'm so excited. Are you excited about MLS Next? No. Why not? You don't know. Okay. Well, I'm not excited about it either because it went from exclusive MLS Next. It's exclusive. These are the elite of the elite. But there's MLS Next 1, MLS Next 2. And guess what? There'll be a third as more and more parents get sold on this garbage. It's the same people of DA. It's the same people. They'll ruin it somehow. We have to stop falling for this. You don't need club soccer. You don't need to pay for it. What you need to do is make a decision and say, you know, I want to embrace the game a little bit differently. Like, I'm going to love the game. I'm going to train a lot. I'm going to train in my backyard. I'm going to play on the school team.
Third time's the charm?
Is it? Are we on Facebook? I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know how to figure that out.
Well, and make sure we save it so Rojo's back. Yay! It's working on flipping Facebook. Hold on. We're live now again.
We're in the garage.
Can you stop? No. Hey, the only reason I'm continuing this show because I'm announcing the top two coaches. Well, two coaches I respect and try to get them. Can you stop? Put your mask on. Okay. We're live right now. People are making fun of you.
I just muted him. We're good.
No, you can leave him on. Come on. Hey, you're actually, if Jack comes in, you're going to go hang out with Scary Baby.
No.
It looks like the turtle from Kung Fu Panda.
Yeah, well.
Never. I'll leave here.
Okay. Put your headset on then.
I'll literally die if I went there.
Okay, put your headset on. All right, we got to get moving on. We have a lot to cover still. We're going to start off where we ended, right? So where are we at? MLS, we just finished reading the Overlay 3 MLS pledge.
Yes.
And I went on a long rant about random things, but we'll just have to move on. The problem that we've had with MLS Next and company is we keep falling for the same stuff over and over again, mainly because parents are forgetful. That's you.
Me? Oh, sorry. I was watching Jet. He's cracking me up. He's very distracted.
Parents are forgetful.
Parents are forgetful.
I got a short memory, just like when I was in the third grade. Two of the best years of my life.
Play it again.
I got a short memory, just like when I was in the third grade. Two of the best years of my life.
That's right.
Two of the best years. Two of them. Third grade was two of the best years of his life.
We take one week off, and this is what happened. We don't know what to do. We actually have a pretty good, cool setup, but we obviously have problems. We have a ton of problems, but stay with us because I'm going to announce my list of two coaches I respect that you should choose as a parent or player to play for them, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, but please comment. What are your thoughts on this repetitious cycle we're in of being fed of, oh, we're wonderful. You know, we have the future of development by the same code. It's kind of like this spouse that just gets beat down nonstop, but they keep coming back for more just over and over again. Are you doing other work when we're doing this? Like, what are you typing?
I'm typing down when we had our comments up. I favorite the comments and questions, so I'm trying to get one down from memory.
Because when I went over there, when we were having those problems, I saw some like different websites.
Oh, that's while you were taking a phone call.
Mm. Okay.
So wasn't the only one off.
Well, I just wish we lived in a world where everyone was just brutally honest about every little thing. Like, just be honest. you're not good. You know, like, just be honest. I can help you get better. Not sure, but we'll talk about two coaches that can actually help you get better. And I'll add one to two coaches every week, and we'll have the great wall of greatness of what I consider great. You might not, but we can always argue about those things by leaving a comment. But yeah, we need to be brutally honest. Video 3.8.
It's never the kid's fault for lack of talent. It's the coach. You ever get this family, they got to complain to the coach? They come up to the coach, "Coach, you want to come here?" "Yeah." "Hi, we're the Gibsons." "Just wondering why my child Tyler's not participating in the game with the rest of the kids." "'Cause he stinks."
He stinks. He definitely stinks. But yeah, we just need more honesty. I guess we can have, you know, we can be nice about it, but so many people get offended. So many people have to just go get their pillow soaked with tears of they were mean to me. And I get it. I feel those same things. I don't know. I'm a conflicted human being. I want honesty. I guess the best way to be, you got to be nice, right, Deadpool? You just got to be nice. Yeah, see, we got to be nice. And, but be honest. And there's a way. I'm trying to work on being honest and being nice same time. It's a struggle. I went to church today. I repented a little bit. And I'm going to have to do that every Sunday.
Hey, Deadpool, how do you think Dave over here is doing with that task? Is he getting nicer?
Am I nicer?
Is he? Be honest with us. No?
Oh. I'm just wondering, where is Jack? I want him right here.
El Rojo? He might come back.
No, tell him to get back here.
Oh, Jack, you need to get back
telepathically?
Here.
Get back here, Jack.
Well, we're almost done. Phoenix College beats Pima for the third time in a row last week, and that's what we're going to discuss last Sunday. And Coach Cosgrove actually called me just not too long ago. In between, I'm like, "Oh, you don't watch my show?" And he goes, "No." Yeah, he doesn't watch it. But since he doesn't watch it, let's rip on Pima, shall we? Let's. Such a cool video. And thank you, Lexi. 2014. So there's a... This game is actually 2019 home game. We won 1-0. And let's fast forward it, Ryan, to the tail end of it so we can watch us score and celebrate and watch Coach Cosgrove cry on the sideline.
Not sure how far into the video.
I don't know. Get there. Yay, we scored. And that was the sweep of Pima. And it was awesome. But we played last Saturday. We didn't have footage, and that's the only footage I have had. We didn't record it because I didn't have anyone who can record. I need to get one of those green cameras everyone has that videotapes without people helping. Because people that help always mess it up. So you just need the solo cameras or whatever those are. Anyways, if you know what camera I should buy so I don't have to depend on others showing up, and because of COVID, if they touch the camera or the screen, it's going to spread and kill grandma kind of thing. Nah, kidding. But what camera should I use? Comment. Let me know. And we'll go from there. But I'd like to show you, and lead me on, Luis Gandara scored... it scored two goals in his soccer career at Phoenix College, and both of them game winners against Pima. He just scored the game winner this past Saturday, and he scored the game winner at Pima in 2019, which we're going to show right now. This is a great footage, and I can't see it, Ryan, because this screen isn't working for me over here.
Well, should I be describing then?
Well, I don't even know what's going on. goal. All right, we celebrate. There's one. And then there's two different angles of it. But what a great, great finish. Oh, wait, I can watch it on my Facebook. So, yeah, it was a
second angle.
It was a great goal by Luis Gandara. And he had another ridiculous goal on Saturday to give us a game winner. And you know what happened? You know what happened after we beat Pima, the number one team in the country?
What?
Almost nothing. The NJCAA rankings, they pay attention to them. They focus on them so much. What are we watching now? Is it still on?
Yeah. Well, we were seeing another angle, and then we saw the sky for a little bit.
Oh. Oh, because the camera guy went celebrating.
Okay.
Yeah, he went celebrating. He dropped the camera and just went. So you have to hold on to it or it goes straight up. So the NJCAA comes back, you know, with their thorough work of commitment of doing the rankings. Phoenix College, who was number 5 in the country, beats the number 1 team in the country. And we ended up being number 5 in the country again. What the flip? What are you going to do? We beat Pima 3 times in a row. We won conference in 2019. At the time, we were first in the conference. Beat the number 1 team in the country. And no movement. And the team in front of us, from back east, I forgot the name of it, they tied an unranked team, and they stay at 4. So if you're going to do rankings, which they do matter, because if you're highly ranked, you'll get the at-large bid and you go to nationals. But they don't care. So whoever's doing it, they just don't care. Don't do the job then. At least put an asterisk on there saying, we don't care. We're just going to let it go. And then Pima drops a 2, and then a team jumps up to number 1 from 3-1. And they haven't played a game in 4 weeks because of COVID. I'm sorry their games are getting canceled because of COVID. How does that propel you to number 1? Are you better because you haven't played in a month? No. You know what really bothers me in a little bit? Mesa Community College, who's not even playing this year, is ranked in the top 20 for 3 consecutive weeks. Yeah, the NJCAA, you care. Just do your job. Whoever is a part of the NJCAA that's governing the national rankings, if that's one of your responsibilities, and I get, oh, it's soccer, we gotta do work. I don't want to do work. I don't want to, I'm not even going to think. Then don't do it. Am I wrong? Comment. Am I justified with my anger about their inability just to pay attention? Am I wrong? Then don't do the job. It's ridiculous. Anyways, I'm off on that rant. Phoenix College doing well. We did lose to Yavapai last night. That was unfortunate, 2-1. Why are you staring at me like that? Don't stare at me. I
use your words, dude.
Yeah, you're not going anywhere. You need to get that mic on and start talking. No, you look how I feel. But we did take out Scottsdale, so we went 1-1. But what's unfortunate, I mean, Yapai's number 7 in the country. But because we lost, I don't know what they're going to do. We might go to out of the rankings because they don't pay attention. Oh, PC lost. Let's punish them. You know, whatever. I'm very excited for Phoenix College and what they're becoming because we are a very talented group of there's a very talented group of athletes on Phoenix College, and we're hopeful everything will work out. But let's get to what everyone's been waiting on. Who are the top coaches?
And just before that, we're going to have a question.
Okay.
That is strongly paraphrased because I cannot remember what exactly it was, but I think this is accurate. Rick Tillman asked a question. If you're here, Rick, and this is wrong, please correct me. What questions should parents ask when looking for a coach or a club?
But the thing is, whatever you ask, because majority of the coaches and clubs out there, there's no different than going to a car dealership. You're going to get sold something. They're just selling you. They got to make money. But if I was going to ask a question, is I would ask this. What players have you developed under your tutelage? How have they gotten better? And I would ask this question. Have you ever had a player that you had to cut after 4 years being with you? That's a great question. Because there's a coach at CCV. Really like, but he posts on Facebook, I had to make a tough decision. I had to get rid of one of these girls on his team after coaching her for 5 years. I had to let her go. It was hard. It's hard to deal with. That's on you. That was your player for 5 years, and you cut her because you suck at teaching technique and development to help them get better. That's on you. Yeah. So it's one thing you're kind of like, you know, they're not committed or whatever, but that's not the way it was painted. You post on Facebook. And I was just like, are you kidding me? That's my podcast. I did a whole podcast about that. That's like episode 79. But it was hilarious. Not that poor girl. She trusted you. She paid so much money to be under you. And what you do to her, cut the living daylights. I was like, you suck. The great thing about soccer is, It's a thinking game, and you can actually get better. I mean, athleticism obviously matters, but technique can find a way. And you didn't teach the technique. But I would, going back to Rick's question, I would watch the coach at a game, at a practice, and see what's being said. Are they allowing development to happen? I guess the question would be, how do you correct mistakes during a game? If they say, I make it right, you know, I don't know what they'll say. I mean, they'll probably avoid saying this, but a lot of them should be honest and say this. If they make a mistake, I'm going to lose my mind and scream, what are you doing? You know, with the ball, and remind them of what they did, which you don't want them to do. So I just don't put much faith into asking coaches anything. They are what they are. You know, watch it, see it. I think you should try as many teams as possible. And obviously word of mouth is going to be important. But I'm just going to give you, I'm going to give you two coaches I respect. And I'm going to give one or two every week. So here's the first two. Listen, not saying, oh, one's better than another, but I don't know enough, but I'll rank them eventually, but I need a pool of coaches. So if I was going to have my son or daughter play for a coach and it was possible, I would have Rick Tillmans, who's asking a question, who's been on my show several times. Why? Because he has similar thinking patterns as me. He's not rude as me, but he has a similar belief system. So Rick Tillman, AKA soccer lawyer. He's been a professional soccer coach since 1997. That's when I got married, which, oh, shoot, our anniversary is coming up. It's our 24th.
Oh, man, you're right.
Yeah, it's coming up May 23rd. And Mother's Day next Sunday. Oh. And we will have a show. We'll dedicate it to mothers.
I'm not going to be here.
Where are you going?
Work dinner.
What? Work dinner on Mother's Day? Were you gonna?
That's Mother's Day?
Yeah.
Your anniversary is on Mother's Day?
No.
Oh, then we're talking about different things.
May 23rd is our anniversary.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
But back to...
I knew that date had some...
Rick Tillmans. he's currently coaching at FC Batavia. He's also owner of Dutch Soccer Institute, director of coaching for, obviously, FC Batavia. He gets it. I mean, a long time ago when I was coaching 96 Hammers, I would loan out players to him anytime just because I knew they weren't going to get worse. They were actually going to be developed, and that matters. He's going to let them play. He's going to allow them to experience a game the way it needs to be experienced. No. Stay put. Almost done. So, the Dutch is a great – would you stop it? They're all about development. Development matters, and you can go back to our past podcast with Rick Tillman's and talk about that. But there's another coach at RSL who I really like. His name is Diego Walsh. Diego Walsh. Now, I know he looks scary, but sometimes you want someone this scary looking because what parent is going to mess with this guy? No parent. Because this guy will mess you up. But you want that kind of, he'll protect the kids. He'll do what he wants because he'll just stare at you with that scary mug of his and get you. But there's actually, he's not scary. Show the good picture of him. So Diego, he's Brazilian, which is always a plus. He played professional all over the place, played Division I soccer. He's actually a really good coach. I've seen him coach. I haven't seen much training, but typically Brazilians, they want it a certain way. They want to play the beautiful game. They want the kids to think. They want that to happen, and development's going to happen. Now, he's also played in Europe. In the English Premier League, I believe. And he's played a high level. He's been all over the MLS. He was drafted in the 2003 MLS draft. But that doesn't even matter because there's a lot of coaches out there that played professional English Premier League, MLS, and all that. That suck. They do. I should do you suck list too. But first, we'll start with the ones that who I think you should entrust having your son or daughter if there's room or they're available. There are coaches like that. So, anyways, this podcast is kind of goofy, Ryan, and El Rojo still won't come in. Mainly because his 2006 Tuzos choked. They're actually really good, and then they had a lot of injuries and stuff, and it didn't work out. So, yeah, they tried though. But in State Cup, the 2003 Tuzos won it. The 2005 Tuzos won it. The 2007 Tuzos won it, and the 2009. RSL team won it, but that was a Tuzos team a year ago. So it was Tuzos team, moved to RSL, and they won it there. So it was really Tuzos. Tuzos won a lot of championships, and the 2001s, they didn't win state only because half the team plays at Phoenix College, and they already have an automatic bid to regionals. So there's for regionals representing Arizona just from Tuzos, 2001s, 2003s, 2007s, 2005s, and 2009s, which is RSL, but it's really Tuzos. That's a lot. Oh, State Cup, that's B-level because we don't play in State Cup. Nope. That doesn't work with me. If your team chose not to play State Cup because you are, it's beneath you, you're a loser, you lost, you're not a state champion. There's only one state champion, suck it. So if you want that state championship and you want to say you're good, play it. Okay. And the reason I always bring up Tuzos is go look at Tuzos, look at the coaches. Not to knock my friends at Tuzos, but where's your licensing? Where's your A license? How do you have the ability to actually be allowed to compete at that level without a license? How do you get your team to play at that level? How is that even possible?
So wait, the last State Cup that they played in or won was in 2009?
Who? No, it's your birth. It's your birth.
Oh.
Yeah, 2000.
So that all happened this year.
Just happened this weekend.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And, yeah. I didn't see super coaching happen, but I saw super playing. So, yeah, it is. And I'm sorry. All my friends with A and B license and all that stuff. I'm sorry. Players win. I mean, you do need licensing. You need high level thinking when you're dealing with an average team and you have to bunker in and just sit in and counter or whatever, or do what some coaches teach. Take them out. Put an elbow to their face so they can lose some teeth. Put cleats up so you can break their leg. Well, that's what happened to PC. Good job. Good coaching there, Tommy. Yeah, I had to go to the hospital twice. Thanks. That was fun. Yeah. Anyways, I won't talk about that too much. But thank you for tuning in. And what a crazy show. And we're slowly getting our podcast room developed in some capacity. K because you're going to be going to Grand Canyon. I saw the cost of that. What the freak? I'll pay it. If you would like to donate to the Grand Canyon University Fund for El Rojo number 2, the female version, donate money now. It's not cheap. You better get straight A's so you get all the scholarships you can. I think at GCU you get some scholarships, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got bumped up recently.
Ooh, yeah, woo. We need it. And we're going to move her there because I need the podcast room. Anyways, thank you.
If you want to be my roommate, go ahead and email us at CoachCameronSoccerPodcast@gmail.com. Yeah. Is that right?
Where are you going? Are you done? Okay. Deadpool is out. It is hot in here. So we will have a podcast room. Very excited about that. And we're going to have some cool guests coming up. And we'll talk about that later. I need to get out of this room. It's hot. And I got to paste all this stuff together. I said a lot of things and I apologize for absolutely nothing. Conor McGregor, thank you for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed this show. If you want more, you can listen to our daily podcast Monday through Friday with more advice on youth soccer development for parents and coaches. You can find us on iHeartRadio, Google Play, iTunes, or wherever else podcasts are found, or go to CoachCameron.com. I don't even know if it's even working, for direct access to our content. See you next Sunday on Mother's Day. Let's see if we can get Mom next Sunday. 7 p.m. Mountain Standard Time.
Yeah, happy Mother's Day. Be on the podcast.
Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do it for you. All right, peace out.